This is an introduction to conical blends in the D³ 2D DCM. Our first example uses a conic to add a blend between two lines. We create the conic by specifying two bounding points and a third control point. Note how the tangent directions at the conic's endpoints always intersect at the third point. This means that when we constrain the conic to be tangent to both lines, the third control point will move to where the line directions intersect. Let's add distance dimensions between the conic's endpoints and the control point. Note how these can be varied independently of each other to give different blending effects, which wouldn't be possible with an arc blend. The conic is fully constrained by specifying a parameter value known as rho. If we construct a line between the conic's endpoints, rho is then equal to the ratio of the distances A and B shown here. Let's constrain the rho value, bearing in mind that the number displayed here is the value of rho and not a distance. We can now vary the value of rho to explore its effect. For rho values above 0.5, the curve is a hyperbola. If rho is precisely 0.5, the curve is a parabola. And when rho has a value less than 0.5, the curve is an ellipse. With the 2D DCM, you can specify rho or constrain it to remain in the range for a specific type of conic, for example, a hyperbola. Or you can leave it unconstrained if you want the DCM to be able to use this degree of freedom to satisfy other constraints. Let's look at a second example, adding a conical blend between two arcs. As it's a blend, we'll make the conic's endpoints tangent with the arcs. If we display a curvature comb on the geometry, we can see that there are curvature discontinuities where the arcs meet the conic. We can add 2D DCM equal curvature constraints to achieve G2 continuity. Once again, we can fully define the conic by specifying a value for rho. The 2D DCM will automatically update the geometry when we change the value of rho. Let's keep rho fixed and modify the radius of one of the arcs. See how the 2D DCM updates the conic to satisfy the changing curvature of the arc. The 2D DCM will solve a wide range of dimensions and constraints on conics. Let's remove the constraint on the value of rho and use a different constraint. If I create a fixed point, I can add a distance dimension between that point and the conic. See how changes to the dimension value updates the curve. I hope you found this introduction to DQ 2D DCM conics interesting. Please get in touch with the DQ components team at Siemens PLM Software if you have any questions.